rooftop. Dallas wins this one 38-14, thanks in part to the ground game.
He was great. He was great. Had the run game going, offensive line gave him holes, and he was physical, really physical, breaking tackles. Some of them I didn't know how he was getting out of them, and just kept going, getting those extra 4 yards. I mean, obviously, we're great for it. Exactly what we needed. I mean, that was Cowboy football. That was to our expectations and our standards. But we can't sit here in this one victory. We've got to move forward. We've got to grow off of this one.
I don't know why people didn't want to talk about Alfred Morris doing it against his old team, but people were talking about Dez and the rookie Ryan Switzer and the punt return from 3 yards out, and also creeping up from the back edge, Marcus Lawrence with 2 sacks.
He's got the throw for him. Rush with the cutback. There, now they got to him. Ball out of time. And the Cowboys have recovered a fumble. It's DeMarcus Lawrence getting the sack. And the Cowboys have their third takeaway of the first half.
So, give them 2 on Thursday night. A league best 13.5. Pretty good through a dozen games. But not as good as somebody named DeMarcus at this table. That way. So what have you seen? Because this is a guy, his first 3 seasons, he had fewer than 10 career sacks. What's taking his game to a whole new level?
I think it's just his confidence level and his progression from his hands technique. And you can see when you get fourth year and your fifth year, you see him getting off the ball. You see him closing a lot faster, to the offensive line, making them stop their feet. And they're starting to do a lot of rush games with him. They're starting to be smart now to where he comes inside and he comes around, maybe runs some type of tick stunt, exit stunt. Look, you can see him winning on his second move. He uses his hands to push, and he also finishes on his second move. Those are some of the things that he's been doing very well, and he's a relentless rusher. And once you're a relentless rusher, when you go in your third and your fourth year, that's when you start figuring out how to be offensive tackle.
Hey, real quickly, I got to call an audible. You two run up to the football up there, and you follow him up there. Just show us what he's doing with his hands really well. Get up to the football.
So I'm going to be 79 today because he looked real stiff, like he couldn't even move his hands or his feet.
Exactly. So if I'm the tackle, if I'm coming around the corner, the first thing is his initial move. He wins with his initial move. The tackle still puts his hand on the defensive end. But what he does, he'll maybe slip his hand under here and dip the rip and come around the corner to finish to the quarterback. Those are the things that you see when the older guys start progressing in to where once you do the move at first, you might get stopped. The second move is when you win and you dip, get around the corner, and then just accelerate to the quarterback. So when you start doing that and really progressing and those types of moves, that's when you start being a great pass rusher. You begin being consistent and start getting pressure on the quarterback.
The other thing is you got to find a duck on the offensive line. like 79 out there today. They was fighting to get over there. No, I'm being serious.
And listen, they had 22 different offensive line combinations.
I get it. You got to take advantage of that. Take advantage.
Well, Washington was looking to take advantage of a Dallas team that had dropped 3 in a row. And Washington doesn't play a winning team the rest of the way. You listen to Josh Norman, he is ticked off because they missed an opportunity here.
I understand. It's really hard. We play. I don't know what we do. We come ahead and play these guys when they come play us. It's the big anticipation at first, and then those lows, man. We can't find a way to get over them. And it's devastating, man. It really is.
Blown opportunity for them, David.
Oh, no doubt about it. You can see him. He was playing good football. I thought they're man coverage. He's running across the field and crossing routes, which is the hardest route to cover for a DB, and he's making plays on the ball, and he's waiting for someone else to step up and make a play, and no one did on the other side.
I'm wondering why they didn't switch him up with Bridges. If you're playing man, it doesn't really matter what side you're on. Yeah. So go ahead and match him up with Dez. So I don't know if he's frustrated because of that, but he's a competitor. Yeah. He always wants to go against the best. He wants to win football games. And like you said, this is the divisional rival. It's one of your biggest rival games you're going to play. So
That's a good point.
The thing is, the team didn't step up when it was time. It was a big game against the Dallas Cowboys, and they wanted to stop the run. They didn't stop the run. And then, Norm, he played a good game, but it was so many penalties. They gave up so many penalties in big plays.
All right, so still ahead, we're going to hear from the future Hall of Fame tight end, Jason Witten. He joined Rich and the guys down there in Big D. Tony Romo calls him the greatest cowboy in history.